Anybody who's been to SEP University has probably visited Ahmedabadi Gufa, or as it was previously known, Hussain Doshini Gufa. This structure is an underground gallery that is surely worth a visit. But before I tell you about the structure, let me tell you about how it came to be. We all know M.F. Hussain, one of the greatest painters of our time. Well, not many people know that he was actually very good friends with the architect D.V. Doshi.
And one day he comes and says, "Mujhe gallery banani hai." So actually, Gufa was not what he wanted. He wanted to have, like in Bangalore and other places, a house or something where he can have his paintings, he can paint and he can sell. So he says, "Mujhe jagah chahiye." So I showed him, because I was connected to the university and next to the SEP campus. So I showed him, "This is the place. Ye chahiye aapke liye." He says, "Theek hai." Then he says, "Kya karenge?" So I said, "You remember the old stories?" मैंने कहा, "तुम देखो हो, पहले मिले थे तब बात कर रहे थे मुझे कि कैसे मकान बनाना है, तो अभी तो तुम भी करते हो, मैं भी थोड़ा काम करता हूँ, तो चैलेंज लेते हैं दोनों के लिए, आप वहाँ पेंटिंग नहीं करोगे और मैं आर्किटेक्चर नहीं करूँगा, कुछ नया करेंगे, क्योंकि वो नहीं होगा तो नहीं चाहिए, सो दिस इज द चैलेंज टू बोथ, सो आई सेड आई विल गो बिलो ग्राउंड, बट आई डोंट नो व्हाट, सो ही सेज ठीक है तो करो, दैट इज हाउ इट केम एज अ गुफा.
Set adjacent to the SEP University, this museum is one of a kind. The spaces are all underground, with only the domed roof shells protruding over the ground level.
When it was built, I took many people there, artists, Kanwarya Center was already built. I knew them well, so I said, "Come and see this." They would come and see. Not yet finished, almost finished. You know, they, no, let it be finished, then we'll tell you how it is. You take an architect, they say, "Why should this be like this?" I said, "No, I want to make a building which is very different."
From the exterior, the Gufa looks more like a work of art, a sculpture of domed shells finished in dazzling China mosaic, complete with a black serpentine imagery snaking across the surfaces. The museum spaces set below the ground contain no straight wall. A surprise when you consider that the function was to house Hussain's paintings.
So once it was built, then Hussain came with Chester Hurwitz, his collector, with a canvas roll. And I had told him, "Ki aap usme nahi laga sakte ho." But he brings a canvas, he tries to put it on the wall. It falls off. Then he tries to get Velcro, and then again he tried. Nothing happened. He was really tired and almost upset. I said, "Maine aapko bataya tha. You have to do something here which you have never done before. Movie kar sakte ho, dusra karo, projection ho sakta hai. Because even the floor also moves."
You enter through a circular door and reach the surreal cavern-like space. Here, the genius of Doshi and Hussain combine together to produce a unique marriage of art and architecture. There are cave-like walls with undulations, with a domed roof shape supported by inclined, irregular-shaped columns.
While we were doing this under construction, my friend engineer told me that if you use brick, you are restricted. But if you use ferro cement, then you are free to do what you like, because they are like soap bubbles. So when they come together, they can create another form. So the original model was with vertical supports. But when we started doing this, we had a problem, so I got hold of the engineer and this Mr. Joshi, and then he worked on the computer, and then those columns and this thrust, like these junctions here, they create a very different kind of a pause. Before that, when I was doing the model, it was straight. So I took it on the table here and shook the whole model. So that is how these forms change their axis. It is like a fruit basket.
The plan being an interplay of intersecting circles and ellipses. The space is an inherent appeal to the earthy qualities in man. Light comes in as shafts through a few circular openings in the dome. The diffused light adding to the mystic ambience. Spots of light on the floor from the circular skylights change location according to the time of the day, adding to the mystery of the space.
So it has been for me the most difficult challenge, and for Hussein also. For many years he did not paint there, he did one line. Then one day he brought cutouts. Years later, just 10 years before he left, he said, "Kya karna hai abhi?" Maine kaha, "Tum dekho, agenda idhar karo." So he took the model, big model we sent him, and he painted that model. Then we painted this in the ceiling. It is the largest Hussein painting in the world.
Ahmedabadni Gufa is truly a structure worth your attention. Do not just spend time here. Sit, explore the spaces. Understand how the space makes you feel. Understand the play of light inside. If you ever feel uninspired, a trip to the Gufa will jog your creativity right up.
I believe what gives you joy, what gives you smile, cannot be measured in price or use. Life has to be enjoyed and rejoiced. So it is not necessary that architecture must have a specific function.
I hope you like this episode of Standout Structures. Let me know your thoughts of the video in the comments below. And also while you're there, tell me any other structure that you would want to see here next week. That is it. I will see you guys next week with another video. Until then, do not forget to like, to share, and to subscribe to Blessed Dark.